people to be able to share something with them and see their joy.
Yeah.
I mean, that's
so honored to be able to witness rapid unity building because...
Hey guys, so I am heading home, or to Joshua's house. I know my hair looks black, but after a couple of washes, it's gonna be light purple. Dark purple right now you can't see it because it's just freshly dyed. I just finished my peach milk tea with bubbles, 30% sugar and 30% ice, and yeah, I haven't eaten anything. I woke up late, I slept late, and surprisingly my stomach hasn't grumbled or anything. I did feel hungry earlier, maybe I was a little bit like cranky, but not too cranky or anything like that. Didn't lash out on anyone. We'll probably go to Korea Joe's for steak tonight. Most likely gonna save my stomach for that. If not, then I'll buy some food later. I'm not purposely starving myself, it's just I haven't gotten a chance to eat and my body just hasn't really kicked in with the hunger. But I know I should eat, so as soon as I land somewhere, most likely Korea Joe's, I'm gonna eat.
Hello,
baby.
I was just wondering who this number was because I don't recognize it anymore.
I will beat you up, baba. How dare you?
Like, I think I saw her like 3 years ago.
Oh my gosh! You saw me 3 years ago?
Yeah.
Oh wow. Wow, baba, wow. You miss me that much?
I don't know, baba.
You don't know what I'm talking about, how dare you? Yeah, baba, it says I'll be home at 8 o'clock. Baba? Baba? Bad boy. Always roaring everywhere. What do you call it? They did my hair for free. Like, they were...
So you didn't pay anything?
I didn't pay anything, but I gave them a little tip. You know, because like they were supposed to tone it for free. The toning was free, but they didn't tone my hair today. They re-dyed it. So I have another month and a half or another 2 months before I go and tone it. They elongated it, baba. Yeah, I have my peach bubble tea.
Always peaching, always bubble tea.
I love you. Oh my gosh. I'm like 1/5 of the way done with my new book. Yeah. I thought this was a good time to just tell you, like, you know what I love doing, some of the self-care tips that I do and self-love stuff that I do to, you know, make me feel like I'm at peace with myself and my life. And number one thing I learned this year, I want to say, because it's already June, and I think that's crazy. This year went by so fast. So one thing I learned this year is to really worship yourself and worship your peace. Literally worship your peace, worship your sanity, worship your boundaries, worship what you know is good for you. And the reason why I said that is because I had a lot of people in my life, and you know, people come and go, and that's very normal, and it's okay because change is good. It doesn't have to be bad, you know. And all the people that aren't in my life anymore, I'm actually like been doing a lot of self-reflecting in the last few months, and it's like I'm grateful. Not because they're not in my life anymore or anything. I am grateful that I don't have to deal with certain things anymore, if that makes sense. But I'm really truly grateful for the moments, the memory, the good things from those relationships, friendships, people, you know. I learned a lot about myself and about others, and I think that's amazing. Like, you know, you're like to be at a place in your life where you feel good, where you don't feel like you have to apologize, you know, and you don't have to apologize for being selfish. You don't have to apologize for doing what's good for you when things have been draining you. And I don't know, I've just been thinking like all these things, and I'm so happy because of those things being gone or still being in my life, whoever or whatever it is, I've grown from it and I learned so much from it. And I'm a better person because of it. Just because you care and love someone doesn't mean you have to put up with certain behaviors, you know? Like I tweeted a while ago, like everyone has a toxic trait. I do, and I've been working on it. The beauty of letting that go because it no longer suit me anymore, or was no longer healthy for me anymore, it has made me realize my own worst trait, worst behavior, my own toxic behavior and stuff. And I realized a lot of these things were times 100 because that person was in my life, you know? And I don't believe that that person purposely was a bad person. I feel like we're all at different points in our lives, everyone. And sometimes when we're at different points than the people around us, it works. You know, they're able to provide insight for you. They're able to tell you and teach you things. But that relationship and that person no longer served me the way I needed to be served in order to be the best version of me. It actually made me feel very violated on the inside. It made me feel like my life and privacy was violated. It made me feel like, you know, my peace was not there anymore. I was being drained a lot, and I'm sure that was not the purpose of everything and every action and stuff, but it just was the result of those actions. And I was really upset that that had to happen, and I had to kind of make that kind of choice. But at the end of the day, you know, I made peace with it because it was for the best of me, and I needed to grow and I needed to become a better person outside of that. And it was really just not for me. And I just think it's amazing how much I've grown and how much I've realized after letting something like that go. And I want to tell you guys this because sometimes we're so afraid and we're so comfortable and we love someone so much that we have to hold on to them. Sometimes the most selfless thing that you can do is let go and let the other person become better too. And although I gotten better, I'm sure that my lack of enabling will make that person a better person too. Because I didn't respect myself enough to stand up for myself. You know what? Now that I let go, I have freed myself of that kind of restriction, I guess. I just think it's amazing how change can be good, you know? When I was younger, when I was 16, when I was a teenager and all that stuff, I was so afraid of change. I was so afraid that, you know, the next thing that happened isn't gonna be good. The next thing that happened isn't gonna be good for me. But no, change is so good, and thank God for change, because if you're in a bad place, change is gonna make it good again. And it's just really about switching your mindset, you know? And yeah, so that's one of the things. I know that was a long ass rant, or long ass story, but I just want to let you guys know that it's okay to let people go. It's okay to welcome new people in your life, new people that will suit you better, that will be there for you for the right reasons. And surround yourself with good, you know, surround yourself with what you know to be good, you know. And people aren't bad. I feel like people were just raised bad, if that makes sense. If they were just raised poorly, so they come off as bad people, if that makes sense. Because at the end of the day, I feel like everyone just wants to be loved. Everyone just wants to be accepted. Everyone just wants to be not judged for the interests that they have and stuff like that. But because people are hurt when they don't have that, or when they feel like they lack these things, they become really bad people. But at the end of the day, I feel like we're just all trying to be people that just trying to be a person that just enjoy their life, if that makes sense, you know? So yeah. And some of the things I've been enjoying is, for the last few months, I found this podcast because I've been searching for like an all girl and self-love and all these butterflies and healing kind of like podcast, but I could never find one. I was looking for months and months and I couldn't find one, until I kept searching and I found the Hey Girl podcast by Alex L. If you go on your podcast app, and just search up Hey Girl podcast, that literally just says Hey Girl, and it's so beautiful. It's exactly what I was looking for. For months I was like about to create my own because I couldn't find what I needed, and this is exactly what I was searching for, and it's so nice. And I would listen to it on my way to work and on my way back to work, and it's just so nice. It's so nice, and it heals and it loves on you, and it's just very soothing, and it's just very like self-care, and I think we all need that. And it's also very inspirational. You hear all these women just opening up about their past, and you don't feel alone, or you feel so related to, or you feel inspired to be a better person and stuff. And I just think that's amazing, you know. Another thing is I've been following a lot of like art accounts, drawing accounts, and just a lot of self-care accounts, and I love it. I love it so much, and it's all so great and makes me feel so good inside. I love bullet journaling too, and I think that's amazing. I've been watching a lot of bullet journaling videos. I recently started watching Lucifer, which is cool too, and started reading again a couple of days ago. I just finished a book after picking it up 2-3 days ago. It's a short book, but I read it so fast because I couldn't put it down. It's called Chinese Cinderella. Happy that I read it now, where I'm not in a bad place and I'm able to be more compassionate and very much more able to handle my emotions a lot more. Because I feel like if I read it when I was a teenager, when I was in a bad place, I feel like that would just probably set me or trigger me and all that stuff too. But I'm really glad I learned and I got better, and I've read it now because it was just such a good book. I learned so much about Chinese history and stuff. I'm not gonna give you any details because I think it's that good that you had to read it yourself. Simple book, it's nothing like huge vocab, lots of text and stuff. It's very digestible, and yeah, it's a good book to read, especially if you want to start picking up reading again. Because I realize long books make me feel like I have so much to do, but if it's short, I'm gonna be like, oh, that's easy, I'm gonna pick up more, I'm gonna read more and stuff like that. So Chinese Cinderella. And then today, as I was doing my hair stuff and whatnot, I started reading The Oxygen Thief by Anonymous. I don't know who the author is because they literally put Anonymous. I don't know how I feel about it. I wasn't triggered or anything like that, but it just kind of reminded the mindset of my ex to me, my bad one, and I thought it was very interesting to just read something like that. So yeah, I talked a lot, really, didn't I? But yeah, I just wanted like to kind of just tell you what's up here and what's here and what you can do for yourself too. And I hope you guys don't feel too sad and whatnot. Life is hard, but it does get better if you keep pushing, if you work hard for it. You know, it's really a lot of work to change your mindset, but it's so worth it once you do. You are more at peace with yourself once you do that, and I'm so glad I'm able to see that now, because 15 year old Shan could not fathom a day like this. Almost like I knew there was good out there, but I never thought I would be at this point in my life. So yeah, I'm gonna stop talking now. I'll talk to you later.